Yeah, it's a 7% beer. And I always want to see what the 7% ones taste like, because most beers are like between 4 and 5%, which is okay. The one that I used to drink, I don't have the bottle anymore, but the one that I used to drink all the time was like an 8% or something like that, 8.5 or something. It was ridiculous. But man, was it tasty, even though it was 8%. Wow. I love the flavor. It's really too bad they stopped making it. I don't know if they like ran out of the hops or something or what. Oh well. It's a document. What's on the document? Nothing. Okay. This person has a dress and a shirt. It's a shopkeeper. Oh, hold on. That's right. I'm on a new island today. Last night I left off at an island I had not been to before. And I'm on that island, and now it's time to go meet the people. Hey, don't close the door on me. Who is that? Freaking Shamino, you jerk. You close the door on me. I'm Chief Master Sergeant William Candy. Yeah. I need to write them a letter and ask them, actually. What's going on with your beer? Your best one, you stopped. Although I do know that like there's a lot of market for IPAs and everybody's into the IPAs right now. I'm not an IPA guy. I mean, I'll drink one. It's not a big deal, but it's like, whatever. Give me something that's alcoholic if you want to give me something that's going to taste like butt. Anyway. Weaving by Carlin. This is a complete source book for a variety of patterns. Included are patterns for clothing, blankets, quilts, and sheets. The introduction even includes a section on weaving one's own cloth. Take the bale of wool and stretch it out across the wheel to make the thread. Once that is done, pull the thread across the loom and begin weaving. Shortly, thou wilt have a nice stretch of cloth from which canst make a variety of useful things. For variation, use different colored threads on the loom to create exciting patterns. Alright, is there a loom around here I can try that on? Because, man, if I have to brew my own beer to make good beer that I like. Apothecary's desk reference. Oh, here we go. Okay, so black will make you invisible. Blue will put you to sleep. Orange will wake up anybody who is asleep. Purple will magical protection. Okay. White potion will illumination. So white potion. Wait, hold on. This one is for light, and yellow, this will heal you. Okay, cool. Green is poison, and red will cure poison. Okay. I need to keep a copy of that. Somebody needs to carry a copy of that. Out of what? Where is everybody? I saw. Here it is. An episode of Good Eats, starring Alton Brown on the Food Network. I saw an episode of that where they actually talked about how to brew your own beer. It was kind of cool. He did have a couple hundred dollars worth of equipment, of course, but still, it was kind of cool. What is this book? The Intrinsic Complexities of Investigating a New Species of Flora in the Land of Bretagne by Perrin. This scientific journal describes with examples the process by which one studies plant life. The book is divided into multiple sections, one for the layman, one for the hobbyist, and one for the learned scholar, and includes a warning about the difficulties of gathering specimens from the poisonous swamps. Of course. The poisonous swamps. The swamps of sadness. The poisonous swamps of sadness. Bromber's Flora by Bromber. Most of common plants indigenous to Britannia. Oh yeah, I've read this. The Reaper is also capable of self-animating as well as self-locomotion. We've seen that. We've seen the Reaper. The Accidents of Armory by Legge. This book on heraldry not only describes various houses for ease of recognition, but also demonstrates elements used in their conception. Thus, this book only will also permit the reader to formalize an heraldic symbol of his own. Yay! If I could. Now, this is Karina's total body workout. That's totally, I've read that before. What is this? It's just a ring. It's not a magic ring. Oh, that's too bad. I suppose I could steal their ring. Who is this? I'm just walking into people's houses randomly at night. That's a mage over there. And then I'm opening the door. They're sleeping soundly. I'm just coming in here and being like, hello, little mage. What are you doing here? Ha 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 ha. He saw me. He woke up. All right, let's talk to this guy. You see your old friend, Mariah? What the flip? What's your name, by the way?
Surely thou dost recognize thine own companion, Mariah.
I don't really know who Mariah is. I didn't play the last two games. I kind of feel like I should play the last two games now. Who is Mariah? Do I have the hots for her? I don't know. Kind of a cute picture.
Yes, dost thou not recognize me? She pauses, glaring at you. Yes, dost thou not recognize me? She pauses, glaring at you. But who art thou, and where are my pastries?
What the fuck? Why did she ask that? What's your job? She smiles.
I have a very important job. I do. Are not these shelves lovely? So neat and orderly. She looks back at you. Be careful. The ink wells are full, and the quills are sharp. The quills so sharp.
She giggles. What? Who is this chick? I'm gonna play some fantasy music today. We'll get into this Ultima 7 while I am fucking shit-faced. This is my third one right now, actually. This is really fucking me up. All right. So the eagles are full and the quills are so sharp, she giggles. All right, what's your job? Oh, I've already asked her that. Okay, so what about the quills?
Oh, yes, they're quite sharp. Always there when one needs a scrap of misses. They do an excellent job of having many ready at a moment's notice.
They.
Yes, they do, her face turns sad. But I only sell.
What the fuck? Is she like mentally retarded or something? You only sell?
Yes, she agrees. I do indeed sell. I even spell. In fact, I even sell spells. But if thou desirest a reagents, thou art out of luck, for I only sell those during one of the 7 weekdays.
What the fuck? Wouldst thou like to know which day?
Only during one of the 7 weekdays, which thou likest to know which day? Okay. What a lovely set of books thou must have. I have just the item for thee to match thy shelves. A potion. If thou wilt buy a spell or reagent for me, I will sell thee a potion for only its normal price.
What the fuck? Why, lady? Why would I? I want to smack her now. Actually, I want to murder her, because that's the only thing I can do in this game. Potions.
What would I like to buy?
Black potion or an orange potion? What the fuck? Why do you only have two shitty potions? One makes you invisible. What does the orange potion do? Wakes you up, if I recall. I don't want either one. Actually, I think I want a black potion.
Black potion sells for 90 gold for 1 vial. Does that like the price?
Yes. I don't carry that. I don't remember who that is, but he will carry it. I'm going to take the invisibility potion over to the guy who will turn it, who will use it to make everybody silent at the Empath Abbey, which I would love. But anyway,
would that like something else?
Yes. Nothing. Fine, she says. Reagents?
What would that like to buy?
Nothing. Garlic, ginseng, mandrake root, nightshade, black pearl. Okay, I gotta write this down, actually, because I think I would like to know. Because this is a pain to go by without memorizing this stuff. Oh, and also orange and black potions. And let's see, what else we got? Which day?
Why, today, thou art in luck. Buy a spell.
Which circle art thou interested in? All of them? Eighth circle.
What spell would I like to buy?
Invisible All, Sword Strike, Time Stalk, Resurrect. Oh, Resurrect sounds good.
The Resurrect spell will cost 40 gold. Agreeable?
Yeah, that's dirt cheap. I will get another spell for that amount, please. Eighth circle. And this time, let's get Invisible All. Yes, 100 gold is just fine. I have, like, 600 gold. Yeah, what else we got? What's in the seventh circle? Mass Might, I don't know what that does. Energy Mist, Restoration, Energy Field? Let's try Energy Field. Yeah, 100 gold, bucket, whatever. Eh, I'm probably good there. Okay. Inkwells. They are always so full and ready for use. They're so good about keeping them filled. They are so good about keeping them filled and clean. Who the fuck are they and who are they? Yeah, exactly, who are they? Yes, they do, her face turned sad, but I only sell. What the fuck, lady? Except that I can understand that you sell shit, at least that's obvious, but cripes! Your conversation skills. Shelves. Are they not the neatest, most orderly, and well-kept shelves thou hast seen? They do an excellent job of maintaining them. They! Oh my god, you suck. I can certainly come back anytime, and bye! Well, I'm about to just fuck it, murder you. No, kill her. Kill her in her sleep. Kill her in her sleep. We don't need her guiding around here. She's such a fucking weird bitch. Now we have to kill the guards too. Oh, we gotta kill the guards out here too. Oh my god. Oh, well, hey, I think we're winning. I think we're winning. Well, I'm unconscious. Oh no. Oh no. All right, let's reload. Man, it's like that is some of the most annoying dialogue I've seen in a while in this game. Wow. I know where. Says the parrot. What books we got in here? Memento Rays, a qualitative study in metaparaphilosophical radiation by Memento. Despite Falcrodon's theory of 0335, there are indeed rays of energy that constantly bombard Britannia. And in fact, these very same rays permeate all of known space between Britannia and the stars. Recent experiments have proven my theory that these rays, known hereafter as Memento rays, are lethal to all non-living matter. And what? Are lethal to all non-living matter. What the fuck? In fact, Memento rays have demonstrated their ability numerous times, once killing an entire boulder in a matter of a few hours. Okay, this is my recommendation, blah, 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 blah. Nutty shit. Birds of Britannia by Brother Wayne. Bound here is the comprehensive guide to the avian species, beautifully and colorfully illustrated by many different artists. Surprising to many is that the silver-winged Farsalot is not the most prevalent bird in Britannia, though arguably the most visible. I haven't seen one yet. Far more popular is the black-tipped crackle, but its predilection for dark, cool areas make it considerably less visible, except that's a misspelling. Okay. The Transitive Vampire by Karen Elizabeth Gordon. This richly detailed tome is a handbook of grammar for the innocent, the eager, and the doomed. Birds of Britannia. Bound here is a comprehensive guide. Okay. Surprisingly to many is that the silver-winged Farsalot is not the most prevalent. Okay. And that was all. I already read that. What's the next one? Thy message received by Forlim, translated by Jillian. Within this diary is revealed the poor treatment of the gargoyle race since the return of the Codex 2 centuries ago. To have noticed that humans remain uncomfortable with us, they have given us our own island to populate, but is this gift designed to keep us segregated? To have wondered why so few gargoyles leave Tarfin. To have no more doubts, having lived in Vespa, to see the hatred for our race, to see, to feel the disgust, to understand not, for it was humans who destroyed our land, not gargoyles. To seek communication, to seek friendship, to seek trust. To speculate that none are forthcoming. To ask the humans why. To seek the terror and loathing and to know there will be no answers given. To hope for a future of harmony, but to realize that with segregation, there can be none. To hope for education of both races, for our children and ourselves. To hope and to live. I think there's some Gargar-related stuff later. The Right Stuff by Perrin, and I have read this one before. Landships by Equinestra, I've read that one before. The intrinsic complexities of investigating a new species of flora in the land of Britannia by Perrin. I have read that before. Follow the Stars by Lornan. This is a guidebook for navigation, with most of the pages illustrating various constellations and heavenly bodies. The final sections contain maps useful to any ship map or captain. Shipmate or captain. Up is Out by Goodfellow. Herein is discussed the most current theories on gravity and mass. After years of study and research, the author finally put the fruits of his labor down in the research in the pages of this tome, which includes his discussion on falling apples. What Could Be Left But the Ashes by In Flames. Herein are the many essays covering an in-depth study of the aftermath of the volcanic eruption. The work was extensively researched and is filled with testimonials from many a survivor. The most interesting story is told by Fandora, a young woman from Minok who claims to have experienced a volcanic eruption near every one of the five towns in which she has lived. And I have read that book before, I realize now. Weaving by Carlin. I've read that one already. And Mentor Raids. Okay, cool. Is there anything in here? No. Is the book pink or is my phone display playing tricks? Yeah, nothing is pink. It's just on your phone display. Sorry. It's 4:26 in the morning. Murder by Mongbat by Jay Dial. This extraordinary work depicts an enthralling but far too gory thriller. Chapter after chapter describes innovative and impressive ways to disembowel people and animals. All right. Ultimately, Avatar Adventures by Rusa DeMaria and Caroline Spector. And within the pages of this tome are the details of the mini adventurous exploits of the Avatar. Blah, blah, blah. I've read all that. Okay. What, this one? This one? What's in this? A Baker's Handbook by Settlar. The fundamentals for baking all come from knowledge of how to perform one simple task, baking bread. If thou art able to do that, thou canst bake anything from meat pies to tarts for thy guests. It is important to set the flour first upon the table. Many bakers prefer to manipulate the dough on the hearth itself, but I prefer preheating the hearth. It makes for more thorough baking, so that is not possible. What? To the flour, add water, misspelling, and mix until the two are well combined. The dough should be damp enough to be kneaded easily, but it should not be runny. Now is the time to place dough on the hearth and bake it. After but a few minutes, thou wilt have quite tasty bread to eat. This is terrible instructions for baking bread. Now the next item will prove a true treat for thine loved ones. That's a terrible instruction. Who would listen to that? Who would read that and be like, yeah, that's useful. Yeah, I can make bread now. Who the flip would do that? All right, that's cute. Anyway, Stranger, Strange End by Robert Heinlein. Robert Heinlein's cool. That's a bookmark. What else we got here? Gargoyle Like Me by Darak. Within this work lies a fascinating novel of a human who poses as a gargoyle to view what life is like from the gargish point of view. The story is a remarkable mix of historical and entertaining facts from encounters with many gargoyles. A particular emphasis of the work is the importance of the gargoyle family structure. As there is no evidence of gargoyles having a gender, it is odd how close father gargoyles maintain a relationship with their presumably adopted sons. The attitudes seem similar to that of how the more intelligent winged gargoyles treat the wingless. There is an air of condescension, but the feelings of care still exist, as if the wingless were children to be protected and watched over by the winged. Huh. I did not know that the gargoyles felt like that. Trees and Then Some by Ben. Previously titled My Life as a Woodcutter, this classic volume pleased readers more than two centuries ago. Much of it reads like a journal, with humorous commentary added by the author between groups of entries. Day 7. Today I received yet another order for more logs. Day 11. I'm amazed at how frequently people are requesting my services. There is no longer any doubt to the rumors of the rapid growth of Britannia's urban areas. Day 16. Found a new species of tree. Was silver-looking
was silver licking these that sparkle and grow quite large. Another misspelling there. Size indicates that the trees live very long, but grow slowly. The 28 had an odd request for a few of these new silver leaf trees. I've read this before. Day 40. Number of requests for silver leaf has nearly matched that of ordinary trees. Wonder what they could want them for. I wonder why everyone has become so crazy for these special trees. I doubt even one so insane as Lord British's Chuckles would pass these off as any sort of precious metal, though if anyone would, we all know it would be the man who carries so much weight that with Lord British, the weight of wine bottles, that is. Yeah, okay, that was, I read it before, I shouldn't have read it again. Who is this? Sage. Alright, I think I've read all the stuff there is to read. I don't think there's much to steal here from what I'm looking at. Let me go upstairs. So I either have to pass the time until morning, or I have to just wait until morning, or just wake everybody up. I'd rather kind of wait until morning, or pass the time. Miscellaneous cantrips. As the title says, this book describes the minor spells that fall into the bailiwick of charlatans and prestidigitators. Ritual magic by Nicodemus. The ability that combines one's power with that of another mage's is a fundamental to the crafting of enchantments. I think I've read this one. While standing in an outer triangle of a pentagram, up to 5 wizards may enhance the effects of their spells, the bloodletting from either a goat, sheep, or cat, 1 per mage. Wow, it's necessary. Can I do that? Can I make some, can I let some blood in a spell? I would love to do that. In addition to the consumption of the secretion of type 3 acid slug, can I do that? Once all the materials are gathered, each mage must stand within one of the 5 corners of a pentagram drawn from the dust of a dragon's thigh bones. I'd like to take drugs and kill things, you know? I want to see can I do that in this game? Anyway. No One Leaves by R. Allen G., the sequel to The Day It Didn't Work. Jortum offers insight to why new mechanical contraptions don't always function at the time agreed upon between mechanician and overseer. I've read that one already. Okay. Okay, so I've read all these. How about this one? Lord British, the biography of Britannia's longtime ruler by K. Benos. While many may remember that Lord British was once but one of 8 monarchs back when the lands were known as Sosaria, few are aware that he is not even a native of our own lovely Britannia. I have read this before. His origin from another world, etc., etc., where the Avatar comes from, the Moon Gates, and the Gargoyles. Okay. Play directing, analysis, communication, and style by Francis Hodge. Within the pages of this highly respected textbook, one can find the highly touted and sometimes controversial methods of staging a play written by an eminent professor emeritus from a university in a distant land. This book is considered by most thespians as the definitive source book on directing. On Acting by Laurence Olivier. Within the pages of this tome are the theories and philosophies of acting, as well as personal anecdotes written by a noted thespian of a distant land. Apparently, this book was one of the many brought to Britannia by Lord British. Jesse's Book of Performance Art by Jesse. This anthology is filled with many performance art scripts. The author, a controversial and eccentric Britannian actor, maintains that many aspects of both acting and performance art are quite similar. Consider the actor. He uses dialogue, facial changes, and movement to convey his lines. His actions, called a performance, combined with the playwright's script, express an emotion or a message. The performance artist uses the very same techniques. The one possible exception is that he is both the writer and the performer. In fact, the practice of many facets of performance art can better an actor's skill. All right. The Symbology of Runes by Smidgen the Green. Found within is the complete dictionary of terms for understanding and translating runes. Not that it helps me any. In addition, the work discusses in depth the relation between runes and magic. Based on the intense text within, it would seem that the author is either a profound dolt or a simple genius. The Art of Field Dressing. I've already read that one. Lady Lay of Serpent's Hold. What? Hold on. There was a 4? Though I personally advocate the use of healing herbs in more sterile bandaging environments, the steps told in this treatise will suffice until better healing care becomes available. Follow Creston's steps carefully, and thou wilt have no trouble forming a reliable, if not perfect, but way to prevent serious blood loss. Remember, however, that there is no care as good as clean sheets, a study bed, and proper attention. Lady Lay of Serpent's Hold. Except when you get those sheets dirty, am I right? Okay, whatever. As long as one has shears, cloth, and a conscious mind, thou wilt have little fear of bleeding to death on the corpse-littered fields of battle. Switching to your PC? Alright. Is your phone done? You're done with your phone looking all weird at you? The screen itself is kind of pink. It's kind of on the pinkish, peaches side. Now, if you're talking, like, what I didn't understand earlier was that if you meant this page is kind of pink, yeah, this page is kind of pink. Not really deep pink or anything like that, but a little bit. But if you meant the book itself here, kind of pink, like these are, that's brown, that's blue. None of these are really pink. Anyway. So they cut the cloth into strips. As the cloth begins to soak up the blood, it will combine with the natural healing aspects of the body to staunch the flow of blood and to quicken the healing process. In no time at all, that will be ready to travel again, though I advise this travel to be to the house of a competent healer. Pathways of Planar Travel by Nicodemus. Herein are the many complex formulae necessary for travel between and through the many diverse planes of existence. Each plane is accessed by a moon gate, and even our very own Lord British came to Britannia from one of these planes via a moon gate. However, this also leads to some concern. To this point, every individual who has entered Britannia from another plane has been benevolent, most notably Lord British and the Avatar. But if they have the ability to employ these gates, is there not the chance that other evil beings might, too, be able to adventure into our fair lands at their whimsy? Thought to be considered for the future. Thou art what thee eats by Fordros. You meant the paper. Okay. Yeah, my bad. Within these pages, thou wilt find the comparative analysis of many of the things we humans place in our bodies in the name of food. I've read this. All right, that just tells you that mutton gives you more food than other foods do. In fact, it looks like it's time to feed people. Are we done? Are we done feeding? Yeah, see? I bought a bunch of mutton. Now everybody's flipping full. Only one mutton per person. They won't eat anything else. Okay. What are these books? 101 Ways to Cheat at NIM by Dr. Cat. Within the pages of this tome are all the many ways to earn supplementary gold by gambling at NIM. Written by the originator of the game himself, this book covers in depth such strategies as claw first, ask a question later, and there are no ways to skin a cat. I guess I'm going to leave this here. I suspect very strongly that is going to come back later. That I think that's the, you know, okay, so you know this map that's up here, or this map, this chess game looking thing, Knights Bridgefield, is this NIM? Is that what it's supposed to be for? I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. I thought that might be, I thought this said something about NIM on the, well, it said the name of it, whatever, okay. Maybe it's not that at all. But I'm going to hold on to it until I find out for sure. To Be or Not to Be by Wislim. To be the words comprising the complete gargish primer. Oh, it's Gargoyle. To be the words comprising the complete gargish primer, designed to educate the young gargoyle mind, both winged and wingless. Rider on the Cat by Mouse. This text is a puerile diatribe and should be taken as nothing more than such. Any of the following activities should only be performed when water is abundant enough to be in surplus. Draughts are serious business, and this work is in no way designed to integrate otherwise. The editor. The using of buckets to draw water from a well takes nothing more than common sense. However, upon what to use the water is often a more difficult question to answer. Cats are, of course, my personal favorite objects of such torture. Row. But thy friends will usually do quite nicely. providing they have no form of retaliation and are not quick to anger. Children are a little less choice, though considerably more deserving, for their parents do often anger quickly when their offspring is threatened. Okay. Does that mean... Oh, Knightsbridge! Oh, here's a Knightsbridge thing. Knightsbridge in a Nutshell by Nicodemus. This is a board game for two players. Each player begins with three pieces. The object is to move the three pieces in concert in order to force the treasure from the center of the board to thine own side. Oh! All the while, thine opponents shall be attempting to do the same. Each turn consists of a player either moving or pushing a piece followed by a similar action by the opposing player. A legal move consists of placing one's piece in any adjacent unoccupied block or white square. A legal push is performed when a player forces a piece either on opponents or the treasure one space directly away from his piece. The exception to the latter rule, making a push illegal, occurs when a player wishes to push a piece into the space from which it just left into the in the preceding turn. Getting confusing here. If any piece excluding the treasure is pushed onto a blue square or off the board, I didn't see any blue squares, but off the board, okay. That piece is considered lost and is removed from play. The treasure may not be pushed off the board. To win the game, the player must push the treasure to the back row of squares on his side of the board. Okay, hold on. Okay, definitely carrying this. All the way. Where am I? What? Oh, I'm not inside. Okay. I'm not outside, really. I have to be outside before it'll give me a location on my map. I'm over here. This is Moonglow. But the chest thing... Okay, I'm gonna check this out. It's the first time I've seen this. So, let me open up my spell book. Let me go back and click help, and that'll take me shortcut right there. See, now we're at Lord British's place. Oh, I'm not inside again, of course. But outside, rather. There you go, I'm at Lord British's place. So now, I just want to run over. Is it faster to take the moon gate? Might be faster to take the moon gate. Run over to the moon gate. Oh, before I get too far here. Here's the moon gate. Let me write something down. And it is super annoying. There you go. Okay. Let's hit this guy. Oh. Okay, not this place. This place? Yeah, it's pretty close. Okay. So if I just go west here, I think. Yeah, here we go. Okay. So, okay, let's look at that book again. Oh, you can't move the book around. All right. Each turn consists of a player either moving or pushing a piece followed by a similar action by the opposing player. A legal move consists of placing one's piece in any adjacent unoccupied black or white square. A legal push is performed when a player forces a piece... Oops. Either an opponent's or the treasure, one space directly from his piece. Okay, let me try this. Can I push this? Can I just, like, take it? Yeah, I'm just gonna take it all. I'm just gonna put it all the way back here. Are we done? I win? I don't get it. Yes, I have all the treasure now. Now what you gonna do? Like, seriously. Do these guys do anything? I can move them. What the flip?
Oh, I can push the treasure off the side. But I can't open it. I can't pick it either. I don't get it. The exception to the latter rule, making a push illegal, occurs when a player wishes to push a piece into the space from which it just left in the preceding turn. Okay, so you can't push a piece into the space you just left. If any piece, excluding the treasure, is pushed onto a blue square or off the board, let me push it onto a blue square then, that piece is considered lost and is removed from play. The treasure may not be pushed off the board. You just said it could, but whatever. To win the game, a player must push the treasure to the back row of squares on his side of the board. Let me put it on a blue square. Does nothing. It's not even, I don't even know if it's on a blue square. It looks like it's actually on the gate, on the fence for some reason. Alright, whatever. That didn't seem to do anything. Hello, magician guy. Can you let me in? I want to play a game with you. Good no, I guess. Gotta come back here and try and mess with that some more, I guess. I keep seeing it. I keep seeing stuff that looks like it might be useful for it, but I don't know. Oh, hello. There's a crocodile here. To the death! Ah, crocodile! I wish you would drop skin so I could make you into some leather boots. The crocodile boots. Where is... damn it. It's around here somewhere. Where's the moon gate? Oh, there it is. Okay. This is not it either. This is up here in the corner. Okay, so now we're back to Moonglow. Alright, let's start talking to the people here. Wait, what time of day is it? Watch says 6:58 a.m. I need to rest another hour or two. I guess I may as well put my roll out. Just rest for a day or two. At least rest for like 4 hours. Come on, there's no room. Stop standing in the way. There we go. Let's give it 3 hours. That's probably enough to give everybody a wait. Give me some healing. Can I carry this again? Oh, apparently I can put it in my hand. That's not what I want to do, though. Why would I put it in my hand? Can I put it in this bag? Yes, I can. Excellent. What is this place? It is... I don't know what. That's an R, I think. I don't know what that is. I don't know. In, maybe? R? No, I don't know. I don't know what this says. I didn't memorize the thing. I should have, probably, but I didn't. What do we got in here that I can steal? Flour? Sack of wheat? I don't want any of that. The ease by four dress. I've read this already. Oh, hey, foodstuffs. Oh, yeah. All I can tell them is to just fuck off, and then they start taking damage because they don't eat. What kind of a game is this? I'm gonna steal. Okay, there we go. I stole all the food. Yay! Need more food to steal? This guy isn't up yet? Come on, man. It's like 9 o'clock in the morning. What the hell? Who is this? Who is this? Fiercy. Oh, I've heard of Fiercy. Okay. Well, let's see if somebody else... Oh, is somebody hungry, really? Okay, it must have been the kid, of course. He's always hungry. Stupid kid. Now I gotta splash some water on a kid. What is this? Topiary. It's a bush. It just told me it was a bush.
It's a bush carved to look like something. What kind of a fancy house is this? Oh my god. Look at the 1% here. Holy shit. What the flip? Is that water? Potion. Lore British, the biography of British's longtime ruler. I've read this. Ring World by Larry Niven. Never read that. Murder by Mongbet. Yeah, I've read that. The Intrinsic Complexities of Investigating a New Species. Oh, I read that. 13 Months in a Year by Urelin. I don't think I've read this. Back already? Wow. This epic details a long, fierce war between swords and spells in a fictional land called Korlothra. The story revolves around a family of sorcerers. In an attempt to usurp his father's power, the youngest brother forms an evil plot of patricide and must be stopped by an outside group of sellswords. And then there was Karen by B. McD. Within the pages of this tome are words that relate the story of how one man's life was changed by a woman, both during the relationship and after. The tale is bittersweet, but both survived to become happier people with better outlooks on their lives. Is Karen supposed to be a modern day Karen reference? I don't know. It didn't work, I read that. That is a potion. That is a red potion. I'm stealing a red potion for damn sure. Stealing red potions. Stealing blue potions. Stealing white potions. Stealing all the potions. No One Leaves by R. Allen G. The sequel to The Day It Didn't Work. Read that already. How the West Was by Euclidia. This tome is a history of this tome of history tracks the geography of Britannia from the early centuries to more recent times. The included maps provide a level of detail never before seen in a work of this nature. In addition, the short chapter on the once important virtues reveals their source from the broader tenets of truth, love, and courage, and I have read that already. Complete Guide to Britannia Minerals, Precious and Semi-Precious Stones by B. Ledbetter. Descriptions of a plethora of rocks and gems. One can find lead in a variety of veins. Oh my god, hold on. Oh my god, shut up! Oh my god, that was so fucking annoying. I'm gonna drop that orrery in somebody's room and hope it annoys them. Anyway. Britannia Minerals. Let's see. One can find a lead in a variety of veins, while a common ore, lead is used with such frequency in items such as horseshoes that is valuable metal to procure. Okay. Gold, black rock. Okay, we've actually read through all that. Follow the Stars by Lornan. This is a guidebook for navigation. I've already read that. Black Moon, Red Day by Urelin. This novel is set in 13 months in a year's Korlothra. The story describes an epic struggle of man against nature as shifting celestial bodies cause violent changes in the land. In the end, only the mighty supernatural abilities of a sorcerer's family can prevent global destruction. Aw. Okay. What else we got here? Cooking utensils. And the same. Why isn't anybody waking up yet? Dude, stop getting stuck. Huh. There must be a magic spell that allows me to open that to do a thing with that. So I think I have to know a certain amount of magic before I can get through here. What is this? That's a map.
Blade of the Griffin by Barony. Blade of the Griffin Barony by Pedrogdi. Pedrogdi. This novel is about a knight's fight against the doctrines of his society with a to win the love of a common man. Okay. Outpost by Gasrith. Betwixt the covers of this volume is invaluable reading for all soldiers. This manual details the tactics and strategies of siege warfare from the point of view of the attacker and the defender. And remember, a soldier's best line of active defense is the cannon. After thy comrades have already loaded the cannon, simply aim the cannon at thy target and fire away. I had a cannon. It fired stuff, but I needed a lot of cannon ammo. So, I don't know. The Light Until Dawn by Drinal. Herein is the short book that discusses both moons of Britannia, Trammel and Felucia, in detail, explaining their orbits, approximate sizes, and expected compositions. In addition, there is a short essay about the possibility of people who live on these moons and how to contact them. The work also includes a short story about a sorceress who discovers a way to change the color of Felucia. After testing her observations, she quickly learns that the changes have little effect on anyone or anything. Shoot the Moon by Oswald. Herein can be found a guidebook for Druidic culture. Details on ritual spells and the organizational structure fill the rather large number of pages that make up this fine wellspring of knowledge. Up is Out by Goodfellow. Most current theories on gravity and mass. I've already read this. Brommer's Fauna, read that. Brommer's Flora, read that. Stealing the Wind. Kite building techniques thou hast never seen before, from the simple box kite to the mind-numbing crisscross butterfly. Each kite is presented in several forms, beginning to end. At the end of the essay is a listing of wind variables and flying styles. Sounds like this person is interested in getting to the moon. I wonder if there's going to be some moon conversations coming up here. There's definitely a lot of moon references. That is, if I could get to this character at all. Living like the 1% up here, jeez. I need magic in order to get across the platform, it looks like. What happens if I do this? Oh, that's right. I can move the camera around and look, but I can't look inside. There's probably a bunch of orreries in there, so we're gonna leave that alone. How do I get back inside? Oh my god. Was it noon already? Dang. There we go. I'm back inside. Alright, hold on. I had two places. Oh, hey, there's the guy. Let's go search the rest of his room real quick. Anything here? So let's go talk to this guy. What is this down here? Green cheese and a kite. Okay. You see a scholarly looking man with a friendly expression. Oh my goodness, finally we found somebody who's awake we can talk to. What's your name? Why, thou mayst call me Brian. Brion, what's your job? I'm the head of the observatory here in Moongrove, he says proudly. This is where the telescope is kept. Okay, and the telescope? I have it upstairs, of course. Thou art welcome to use it as often as thou wishest. In fact, I also have an orrery, shouldst thou desire to see that as well. I stole your orrery, sorry. Orrery. The orrery? Why, it is a model of all the planets in our solar system, including the two moons of Britannia. The orrery moves to match the actual current orbits of our real system. Sure, I believe that. I'm very excited, for shortly a very rare event will occur. What's the event? Thou art referring to what we in the business call the astronomical alignment. The planets and the moons will all line up perfectly, something that happens only once every 800 years. And Moonglow? Why, I love living here in Moonglow. I very much like the people here. Actually, I'm curious about something. When is the next planetary alignment? In 2000, five of the planets, Mars, Saturn, Jupiter, Mercury, and Venus, were within 50 degrees of each other. You may have heard a lot about future planetary alignments, including rumors about 12/21/2012, when some say the planet is world is going to end. Yeah, that was silly. And there will be a planetary alignment. That is, was there a planet? I don't even hear that. That is all it is, a rumor. There would be no planetary alignment. Yeah, okay. I heard it was like an asteroid or something. Maybe the planets will align in a rather straight line in 2010 on June 13th, 2010. This sounds like a really old article. In September of the year 2040, four of the planets, Saturn, Venus, Jupiter, and Mars, will be roughly aligned when seen from Earth. Check out when other planetary alignments will happen and then search them for them in the sky. Okay. The closest that the eight planets will be will come to being aligned. Pluto is now considered a dwarf planet. Don't care. Will occur on May 6, 2492. So we got like 500 years. Okay. I was hoping there might be some sort of weird planetary alignment going on right now because this place is fucking nuts. Anyway. I love living here in Moonglow. I very much like the people here. The people? Why, I love living... Okay. Wait, you just said that. Okay. People, there we go. Hast thou spoken with my twin, Nelson? He heads the Lyceum, or Elad, and surely thou knowest about the mage Penumbra. What about Penumbra? Thou hast not heard why 200 years ago she put herself to sleep. What about Elad? Poor Elad, he sometimes joins me at night to view the heavens. He has been trying to leave Moonglow for many years. He likes the island, but is filled with wanderlust. He smiles. Nelson, I do not see him as often as I would like, for we are so heavily involved with our work. He will be easy to recognize should thou see him. For people tell us we look identical. I do not see it, of course, but for not only was he born with the brains, but also the handsome face. All right, bye. Before thou dost depart, let me show thee a few of my trinkets. Here is my... What? He wants to show me his trinkets? Fuck, man, come on. What are your crystals? This, he says, presenting a collection of crystals that seem to be attached in some indeterminable fashion, is an orrery viewer. It permits one to see my orrery here from anywhere in Britannia. Why would I want to? He seems thoughtful. I know thou cannot stay around here to see the alignment. Wouldst thou like to have this to view mine orrery or better predict the planet's position? Yes, I guess. He smiles proudly. I thought thou wouldst. However, there is one problem. I still need one more crystal to completely finish the viewer. If thou wouldst visit the tavern, thou mightest find one of the merchants or travelers there who sometimes provide me with crystals. If thou canst find another crystal, I'll be able to give thee the completed viewer. Oh my god. Kite. He shows you a kite. I made this myself by reading one of the books in my brother's library. Alright, sextant. He shows you a solid gold sextant. Sounds so fucking wrong. This has been passed on to each and every individual who has ever held the position at the observatory here in Moonglow. It is more than 200 years old, he beams as you return it to him. And the moon. This represents one of the moons that orbit Britannia. He hands the model to you. Taking it, you quickly realize that it is made up entirely of green cheese. That is this thing, I guess. I carved it myself, he says as you return it to him. Ew. Just ew. Bye. Good day, my lord. Thou mayest use mine observatory as often as thou wishest. You sound so wrong when you say it that way. I'm gonna move on from here. That was cool. Where should I go from here? Let's keep going. Let's go find the rest of the town. Like, have I been in here already, I think? I gotta drink all my beer, too. No! Who's this? Fighter. You see a handsome, hardened, muscular man who, surprisingly, bears a friendly smile on his face. What's your name? I'm called Adam, my lord. Adam. What's your job? I travel the world in search of rare and unique items to sell to museums. I am not a resident in Moonglow. Moonglow? I'm afraid, my lord, that I know nothing about this fair city. I reside in you with my wife, Penny, who is the trainer there. Actually, my lord, I have met two people here other than Nelson. Why can't I ask about those other two people or even Nelson? Who is Nelson? All right, whatever, Penny. She teaches close quarter combat, everything I needed to know to survive on my journeys. I learned from her. People. I've come to know the bartender and the healer. Healer? Elad is very generous. Elad is a healer, okay. In fact, he is letting me sleep in one of his spare beds while I'm in town.
His only charge, he laughs, is the stories I tell him about my adventures. Not a bad trade if I say so myself, he shrugs. Bartender. Fersey is quite friendly, but he does love to gossip. Yes, he has offered me a deal whereby I might earn three meals if I could discover why Nelson's assistant reacts... If I could discover why Nelson's assistant reacts differently to some man or something like that. I am not going to bother, but pray do not tell Fersey that. Nelson. He's in charge of the Lyceum. He loves trinkets and rarities. All right, Crystal. Dost thou mean this? He pulls a small, clear, multifaceted gem from a pouch beneath his cloak. I just found this recently. I was hoping to sell it to the Lyceum, but alas, they have no use for it. Dost thou want it, perhaps? He asks, hopefully. I'll sell it to thee for 20 gold. Can I bargain with it? No. Very well, he sighs disappointed. Really? I can't just bargain for it or whatever. Items. I have found many odd artifacts. Many of the things thou hast seen in the music hall. Many of the things thou hast seen in the music hall and the Lyceum have been brought to them by me. Travel. I've been all over Britannia, my lord. Nothing about the land frightens me any longer. He grins. The same is not true of some of the residents. And the residents? 'Twas a joke, my lord. Alright, whatever. So let's buy that crystal. I think the buy. It is always be pleasant, lord. You suck, dude. Where's that crystal? The orrery crystal. There it is. A small orrery. Wait. There it is. Okay, so this guy is the orrery. So what if I put them together? Okay, that doesn't seem to do anything. Okay. Let me go talk to the wizard again. Do recommend there. Why, hello, Sir Dupre. Things fare well, I trust. Greetings, fair Fiercy. Yes, thank thee. Things are well. How may I help thee, my lord? Asked Fiercy. What's your name? I am Fiercy, at thy service, he gives a short bow. What's your job? I am the bartender here in Moongrove. The Moongrove? Thou wants to know what someone in the about someone in the town? Thou hast asked the right person. I know all about the residents here in Moongrove. I would be happy to tell thee about any of the shopkeepers, scholars, or farmers who live here. Or art thou interested in the trainer, healer, mage, or fellowship leaders? All of them. We're going to start with the leaders. Dost thou want to know about the one in charge or his clerk? I'll start with the one in charge. Rankin is in charge of the entire local branch. If thou hast any questions about the fellowship, he can answer them. And the clerk? If thou hast any questions about the fellowship, Belena can answer them. Why do you say exactly the same thing for both? Whatever. Anyway. Leaders. I already asked that. Okay. Hold on. I missed something up. Oh, I asked him about the fellowship this time. Oh, thou refers to this, he asked, pointing to his medallion. Thou hast not heard of the fellowship. I strongly recommend that thou speakest with Rankin or Belena at the branch office. The fellowship has done many things for our town, if not for all of Britannia. I am a firm believer in neorealism. Neorealism? That is the fundamental principle of the fellowship. It is composed of the triad of inner strength, which is strive for unity, trust thy brother, and one other one. Oh, yes. Thou dost get what thou deservest, or some such job. I'm the deputy bartender here in Munglo. Here we go. All right, ask about the leaders. Mage. Oh, yes. Mariah is very nice, but I am more interested in discussing Zelda. Mariah is not nice. She's a cunt. Or retarded or something. Healer. Friendly fellow. I like him. His name is Elad. But Brian is more interesting to me. Wow, why? Are you I can't tell if that's supposed to be a female or a male. A trainer. Chad is a friendly fellow. I like him, but I'd rather discuss Brian. Can I ask about Brian? No. Farmers. Tolemak and Kubalt are brothers. With Mort's help, they run a farm. But I would prefer to talk about Brian. scholars. All the learned scholars I could tell you about Brian, Nelson, Zelda, and Jillian. We're going to start with everybody but Brian. Jillian. Wonderful scholar, very nice woman, married to Ephraim. But I am more interested in discussing Zelda. What about Zelda or Brian? We're going to do Zelda last then. Ephraim. Friendly fellow, I like him. But I'm more interested in discussing Brian. No! Come on, Nelson. He is Brian's twin brother. Speaking of that, I would like to discuss Brian. Why are you weird about Zelda and Brian? We're going to start with Brian, with Zelda, rather. Ah, so thou dost 1-2. All I know is that every time someone mentions Brian's name to Zelda, her serious expression changes to a smile. I have a deal for thee. Find out what their story is, and I will give thee and thy friends a free meal and drink. Thou canst find Brian at the observatory in Zelda and the Lyceum. I can't ask about Brian now. I guess that's the same dialogue. All right. Scholars. All the learned scholars. Oh, I already asked that. Did that. Let's do Brian. Yeah, it is exactly the same dialogue. Okay, cool. Shopkeeper. She is a tailor. Lovely woman, that Carlin. She minds the bar when I go to the fellowship meetings at night. All right. What can I buy from you? Food or drink, my lord? Food. I can buy mutton. All right, cool. For super expensive, 12 gold for servings, for 10 servings. Hold on. Food, mutton, 12 for 10? Oh, fuck yes. That's actually good. How many of the 12 for 10 do I want? Let's get like 4. No, I don't need 4. Let's get 2. That's probably plenty. I will carry some as well. Yeah, agreed. No, I want anything else. No, I don't want, I want to go. Bye-bye. Bye-bye-bye, not bye-bye. All right, so that's the bar. Let's follow the pathway to see if it goes anywhere else. Okay, from there, let's go this way. Where does down go? Oh, a farm. Whoa, 'tis hot, says one of these guys. Blast! Farm with people in it. People I can't talk to? There we go. The man before you shyly looks away. What's your name? Morse? What's your job? I work with Kubalt Farm being here. Okay, stutter Kubalt. It's not funny, he blusters something anyway. How may I help thee, my lord? Stutter. What's the stutter? He turns to leave. Aw. Alright, name, Moors, job. I work with Kubalt, okay. Here. Moonglow, Kubalt. He is Tolomach's older brother. I trust him. Moonglow. He points to the ground. That is here, Tolomach. Tolomach is my friend. I've known him for a long time. He just joined the fellowship. He wants me to join. Oh, goddamn, fellowship. Tolomach says they do many good things that they would help. Help me make friends more easily. Kubalt thinks they're bad. I do not know what to do. Okay. Not with your stutter, no. Oh my god, dude. I actually have met a couple people with a stutter like that. They aren't bad guys, but it does make listening to him, talking to him a little tough. You see a friendly-looking farmer. What's your name? I'm a cold Tolomach, my lord. What's your job? I help my brother tend our farm here in Moonglow. Moonglow? Yes, my lord, that is the name of the town thou art in. Now, dost thou have questions about the townspeople? Well, I do. I know only a few people. Crap, okay. No, not this guy. Okay. Name. Job. Moonglow, okay. Townspeople, okay. I know only a few people here, my lord. My brother, Kobold, runs the farm with me. Mordz helps us too, but we've known him for many years. And now that I've joined the fellowship, I've met a few more people. Rankin is a branch head here in Moongrove, and Belena is his assistant. If thou dost want to know about other people, thou mayest want to ask the bartender. His name is Fierce. Yeah, I already did that. Okay. Rankin. Rankin is very intelligent. He is the one who persuaded me to join the fellowship. I have much respect for him. Extra loud section. Belena. She's the branch clerk. Most of the time, she's friendly. Sometimes, however, she seems a little cold. Mordz. Mordz and I grew up together. He is very sensitive in his stutter, though. He's very sensitive about his stutter, though, so I would not bring it up. What about the stutter? It is difficult to get him to talk about it. I think it was caused by an accident he had when he was a child. I barely remember the incident. My brother might remember more. Your brother? My brother is Kobold. He frowns for a moment. He can be a bit overbearing at times, trying to take care of me, but he shrugs. He means well, perhaps. I know I've caused him a bit of trouble every now and then, he says with a grin, but he deserves it. Alright, fellowship. Rankin or Belena would be the best ones to ask, my lord, but I can tell thee our main tenets. We believe strongly in neorealism, which is a form of optimistic outlook which may be reached through the triad of inner strength. I am hoping that soon I will be able to hear the voice that comes with meeting one's higher potential. Also, my lord, the fellowship sponsors many feasts and festivals. I strongly recommend that thou ask Rankin about joining. Bye. Till next time, my lord. My lord. Alright, talk to that guy. Last guy here. You see a man with an unhappy look on his face. What's your name?
I'm Kobold of Moongrove.
What's your Moongrove?
The city occupies the entire East Island now, including the Lyceum. Most of the residents still live south, though. We're due east of the Britain proper.
Residents?
Zelda, the clerk of the Lyceum, would be the best person to talk about Moongrove's residents. Or the bartender, though I do not know his name. I know the observatory head and the Lyceum head are twins, but I have never met either one of them. I do know that thou dost not want to talk to Rankin or Belena at the fellowship. They are ill news to our once pleasant city.
The fellowship? He spits on the ground.
A bane to Britannia is what the fellowship is. They have some odd philosophy that teaches thee to forget who thou art and follow them. The process is dehumanizing, and I think it meshes poorly with the eight virtues. Not only that, but their leader here in Moongrove has persuaded Tolemak to join. I'm a farmer, my lord. I manage my farm with the help of Tolemak, my brother, and Mordz, our family friend. Take care, my lord.
Can I ask him about the fellowship? Nope. Can't mention his brother disapproval, so I guess that's not a thing. Well, let's go see if there's anything hiding around here in the house that I can steal, because I'm the avatar and everything that's yours is mine, bitch, because I'm saving the world. Oh, I'm stealing food for damn sure. That's how you keep an army of eight people fed. So grab some flaming oil. What else we got here? Garbage. Oh, let's pick that sucker. More garbage. All right. Is it dead in here? No. Oh, wait. No, yes. I already talked to them. Where's this go? Okay, that goes to the moon gate. Where's this one go? What do we got here? Huh. Who's this guy? Stack Rain, he says, you see a lithe-looking fighter
smile in your direction. What's your name?
Chad, at thy service.
Chad, of course.
At thy service, my lord. What is thy name? What is thy name?
I am the Avatar, bitch.
Of course, he smiles. I should have realized that thou were the Avatar. Why, it must have been, at least 2 weeks since thy last visit, he winks. Thou art a fool. Cannot thy feeble eyes see this is the Avatar?
Yes, yes, I can see that, he laughs.
Then I must be Yolo.
No, rogue, he's Yolo, he nods to Yolo.
Thou art a blind idiot.
What's your job?
I teach expertise with blight weapons here in Moongrove.
Mungo, dost thou want the location of the city or to know about the townspeople?
Both.
Location. Mungo is on an island directly east of the border between Britain and Paws. Townspeople.
The person to ask for that information would be Fiercy, the bartender. All I know are other bar patrons.
Ptolemaic and Moors. Two farmers. Alright, train me. 45 gold per training session. Alright. Shimino? Nope. Train. Me? Alright. So it looks like he's not training me. Okay, well, there wasn't much to this guy. I guess he'll train me eventually. If I ever go up a level. I don't even know if I want to be trained by him, though. Alright, nothing here. Okay. What else we got around here? Dead ends. Oh, wait, where's this go? Nowhere. Because there are no boats here. I suspect I should be able to get a boat here, but I don't know. What is this? Encyclopedia Britannica, Volume 2, F through L. Volume 3, M through P. Volume 4, Q through U. Volume 5, V through Z. And Volume 1, A through A. Another volume in a long series of books detailing every known geographical location and historical personage. This work covers Akara, the first mayor of Atrinsic, through Exodus, the vile offspring of Mundane and Magax. This work covers Falga, the ancient sage of reptiles, through Lyceum, the renowned library that is now part of Mungo. This tome covers Kanos, an historical tower in ancient Yu, through Pusmoran, the originator of the rarely used fourth person point of view. Fucking alright. This book covers Quaxalmornicom, the mythological snow beast of the north, through Utopia, the proposed manifestation of the time honored concept of a perfect society. This tome covers Vargas, contemporary storyteller and compiler of legendary parables, through Zyand, a prehistoric island. Alright, cool. What is this? Farmer's Fauna, read that. Farmer's Fauna again. Farmer's Fauna. Flora. Flora. Flora, okay. Map. Okay. Two boxes of all duplicate books. Did a shipment of books crash here and just like kind of leave their crates behind? People forgot about their books that they ordered from Amazon.com. So the people of Moonglow will not get their books now? Because of the shitty Amazon practices, shipping practices. What we got in here? Bunch of nothing? Alright. Really? It's a plate, a fork, and a knife? Seriously? Oh my god. I don't even know what that says. I'm too drunk to care, too. Elad. Alright, I need to talk to Elad. The man looks at you through smiling eyes. What's your name?
Elad is my name, my lord.
What's your job?
I am the healer of the residents of this community.
Community?
Moongrow is mine home. I have lived in this town for mine entire life, but I am weary of my life here. Tis time, I think, to move on. If only I did not have such strong ties here, he sighs sadly.
Ties?
My patients here in Moonglow, who will help them if not I?
Alright, heal.
Yes, I sell mine healing services to those who need them.
Services.
Art thou in need of healing, curing, or resurrecting?
Resurrection? Yes.
Which of my services dost thou have need of?
None of them. Nobody. Residents.
There are many people in Moonglow. My father once told me that the town was much smaller during his time. In fact, he said that Moonglow used to be separate from the Lyceum. But I digress. Thou didst ask about the people.
I know most of the residents here.
Dost thou want to know about the Lyceum, the Observatory, the Fellowship, the Farmers, or the Trainer, or the Tavern?
The Tavern, to start with.
Fiercy tins the bar there. He is another good person with whom thou should speak about the townspeople. However, he enjoys gossip and may be a bit single-minded.
Trainer.
The trainer is named Chad. I believe he specializes in swift, skillful fighting with knives and swords and such. See him if thou wishest to improve thy skills.
I can't anymore. Farmers.
Kubolt owns the farm. He manages it with his younger brother, Tolomac, and their friend, Mortz. If I am not positive, but I believe Tolomac recently joined the Fellowship.
The Fellowship?
I know those people least of all. The branch opened here about five years ago, under the direction of a man named Rankin. A few months ago, a clerk joined him. Her name is Belena.
The Observatory?
The head here is Brion. He is the twin of the head of the Lyceum. I like him, although he and his brother are both a little eccentric.
And Lyceum?
The Lyceum is run by a kind man named Nelson. His advisor is Zelda. Do not break any rules in her presence, or thou wilt receive a sharp reprimand. Jillian also studies there. She can teach thee many things. And do not worry about Mariah. She's harmless, if thou wilt but leave her be.
All right, I'll leave her be, I guess.
I'm the healer of the community.
All right, hold on. Heal. Don't need any, no.
Ties? My patients are here in Moonglow. Who will help them if not I?
All right, bye.
Wait, perhaps I could join thee?
He quickly stamped up, smiling. Then just as suddenly, his smile fades.
No, I cannot. I have far too many things to do, too many people to care for. Perhaps in the future, he forces a smile. I hope when we meet next time, my lord, I will have the opportunity to join thee. Pleasant journey, my lord.
Okay. All right, cool. Let me use the bandaid on this guy.
Does not appear as though a bandage is needed? Really? Okay, I guess he's got plenty on him.
Well, in that case, we're gonna steal all your band-aids, dude.
What was that noise? Who's stealing my band-aids? Oh no! Somebody has stolen all my band-aids.
Can't talk to this guy. He just says arg. Oh, but there's some lockpicks here. Definitely stealing lockpicks. Two of them even. What about here? A banana. You know that banana is gonna set somebody off. No, okay, it didn't set anybody off. All right, cool. Locked.
No, there they are. What the fuck? They just appeared out of the corner of the room.
Avoid the unpleasantries of a lengthy trial. No, I want the full unpleasantries of a lengthy trial. No, they just go straight to murder. If you don't agree to go straight to jail, they go straight to murder. Jesus Christ, really? Fucking Christ. Why is that a response? That doesn't make any flippin' sense. Help, guys, help. Ah, whatever. That's so flippin' silly, I swear. All right, let's pick this guy. Pick broke. No, okay. So, how much have I been to here? That stuff. I think I have the Lyceum I still have to visit. I've been through here. Okay. Wait, this is the other side of the island? Really? Okay, it is. Whew, man, that's 7% beer, damn. Is this the Lyceum? Oh, I've been here. This might be? I don't think it is, though. Wait, there's another person here besides the guy I talked to earlier. I think this is the guy I talked to earlier, right? Oh no, it's just Sage. You see a woman who meets your gaze with an icy stare. What's your name? I am... No, I'm trying to give her a female voice. I am Zelda. What's your job? I am the advisor at the Lyceum. Advisor? Yes, she says. My job is to manage and regulate the events in the Lyceum and, she adds, provide assistance to the people here in Moonglo when they need it. Townspeople. I have little time for this, she sighs. I know only the Lyceum head and his twin, Brion, at all well. The trainer also studies here in Lyceum. In the Lyceum, she studies at the ceiling as if reading from an invisible overhead list. Thou dost already know about Penumbra? How the fuck did I know that? Moriah's here. If thou wishest to know about a member of the Fellowship, ask the clerk there. Otherwise, she eyes you coldly, let me return to my duties. As an afterthought, she adds, and keep thy voice down. People are trying to read. Trainer. Jillian, she is very well behaved, also quiet and tidy. I believe she is an excellent scholar. If thou art going to seek her out, try not to overturn any shelves. Some new books have just arrived, and I have not finished placing all of them. Why would I overturn the shelves if I was going to seek her out? Why would I even be here with your next to your shelves? Anyway, new books. Yes, they arrived not long ago, including the recently discovered copy of Demaria and Spectre's Walk, the Avatar Adventures. If thou canst avoid creating too much of a disturbance, I recommend it to thee. The Avatar Adventures. If I tell thee this last thing, wilt thou depart so I may return to my job? No. Fine. She just leaves. Bitch! Oh, bitch! Bitch. What the fuck? She just go back downstairs again? Ooh, wait! Oh my god! Oh my god, what the fuck is this? You see a young woman with an intellectual bearing. What's your name? I'm Jillian, my lord. What's your job? I'm a scholar, my lord. I also tutor and train those who seek knowledge here in Moonglo. Tutor? My price is 35 gold for each training session. Aren't thou willing to pay that? Yes, train everybody. Which of thou wishes to train? Me. Oh. Spark? Ceremon? Okay, nobody's gonna get trained. I guess we need to go up, like, levels and stuff. Dupre. And Shimino. Okay. Moonglo. The town occupies almost the entire island of the same name. The island is located due east and a few degrees south of the city of Britain. That's all you gotta say. Alright, bye. Bailey, Blondie, she says, returning to her previous activity. Where's that bitch? Oh my god, she's up here. They're all just like flying all the way through this place. I mean, there's so many books here too. They gotta check out. No. There we go. That's me now. Name, job, Lyceum, advisor, events. I'm in charge of maintaining the reading areas and bringing in new books. In addition, I help organize special group sessions for Jillian's tutorials and set up educational entertainment programs. Jillian? Jillian, she is very well behaved. Also quiet and tidy. I believe she's an excellent scholar, etc., etc. Okay. New books? Right? They were not long ago? Okay, I already read that. Tar Adventures. Yes, I guess I'll ask her about that. We discovered the tome in the lower depths of the basement. We have no way to account for the accuracy of the contents, but have noticed some mini parallels between the events of the walk and the events in Britannia's recent history. The book is a copy of the Avatar's diary written about 200 years ago during his most recent visit to Britannia. Of course, she smiles sardonically, it has been annotated by others.
It was recently published to give the general public more courage and confidence. And now, goodbye.
Who is this?
Yes, my lord. Mariah smiles a trifle sweetly. Bye. Certainly back anytime, my lord. I do not want to talk Mariah. She's fucking annoying. Wow, there's so many books up here. I'm not going to read these right now. I haven't actually, for some reason, I haven't actually seemed to have been given a quest. Or anything like that yet. I have to come back up here at some point, though, and, like, start trying to read everything. Who is this? Salutation, Bondi. Who's your name? Nelson. All right, what's your job? From the Lyceum, I am the Lyceum head here in Muglo. My assistant Zelda does all the work. Zelda, she's an excellent assistant. The Lyceum has never performed better. However, she is a little too stunned, I believe, and he leans in again. I think she is quite beautiful. Beautiful? Does thou not agree? I am flushed whenever her fair presence passes by. But, he holds up his index finger, I fear she does not share a mutual attraction, and she is far too serious for me to feel comfortable with a proposal. Stern. She has put an extraordinary amount of time and effort into ensuring the activities in this edifice happen smoothly, and, he adds, she takes it personally when they do not. Mungo. I love the island and the people, mostly the people. The people? Hast thou met my twin brother? He heads the observatory here, and somewhere in the Lyceum thou canst find Mariah. Sadly, she is not well up there. She is not well up there. No, she is not. He touches his head. Jillian the Sage also studies here in Lyceum. A good person to see about other residents of Moogla would be the bartender at the Friendly Knave. Fiercy knows almost all of us here on the island. I have already talked to Fiercy. Oh, and thou must not forget the legend of Penumbra. 'Twas 200 years ago she cast herself into a deep slumber. Now that I think about it, Londi, thou art the one she predicted would awaken her. Better hasten, my lord, he chuckles. Penumbra. Interestingly enough, no one has ever discovered how to enter a house. I believe those mysterious signs at the door require one to have specific items in place next to the plaques. Really? Where's her house, and what items, and what door? Fiercy. No one keeps up on his politics. That one keeps up on his politics, or rather his gossip, he says, grinning. If thou dost want to learn about a resident of Moonglow, visit him. Visit him. Jillian. She rarely has time for visitors, but I know she takes on students every now and then. Mariah. She was once an adept mage, but ever since the wizards began losing their, faculties, she followed suit. And your twin. His name is Bjorn. People often mistake us for each other, but I think we are nothing alike. He got all the looks and the brains. All right, bye. Of course, thou mayest have free reign in the building, but first, he grants, let me show thee my... quill holder? The quill is gone, he exclaims, and what about the... He seems to be searching for something. The matching scroll opener is also missing! Did I steal them? I don't think I stole those. Maybe. Well, maybe I did. Am I stealing a shit book? He gingerly pulls out a leather-bound tome from his robe. He removes a handkerchief and meticulously wipes away the dust. This was given to me by Lord British himself. See, 'tis the first edition. The book he carefully places in your palms is very old, and the gold leaf plating of the title has been almost entirely rubbed off. Turning the book right side up, you can read the title, Stranger in a Strange Land. Whatever, bookmark. He appears upset. I knew someday that would be stolen, he says angrily. I should have known better than to show it to every person who comes to visit. Book stand? This solid brass book stand is matching overhanging candle holder for late night exploration in literature. I invented it myself. All right, that's it. Bye. Good day, my lord. Thou, of course, dost have free reign to the Lyceum. All right. Well, I don't know what else there is to do here. I think I've talked to everybody. Yeah.
That's Jillian. That's Nelson. I think I just talked to Nelson. Yeah. That's Mariah. She kind of does look like Crazy Cat Lady. Who is this? That's Zelda. Okay. I think I got everybody. Who's this? Shopkeeper. Okay. At your approach, the woman raises her eyebrows to indicate she is aware of your presence and interested in what you're about to say. What's your name? I'm Carlin. She smiles broadly. I'm Carlin. What's your job? I'm the Tailor Moonglow. Moonglow? Tis a very pleasant town, my lord. There are so many different types of people here. I wish I knew more of them. If thou hast any questions about them, I highly recommend to thee that thou speakest with Fiercy. What about Fiercy? He's the owner and bartender. Every night at 9 he goes to the fellowship meetings, so I serve refreshment for him at the Friendly Knave. The fellowship? I know little about the group. Every night at 9 they have a meeting or some such of all the members, and if I remember correctly, the leader of that branch doth give a speech. A sermon is what I believe it is called. There's another member in town if thou hast questions about the fellowship. There's another member in town if thou hast questions about the fellowship. Okay. Leader. His name is Rankin. I do not believe he has been here terribly long. Another. I believe his name is Tolomac. He is a farmer, from what I have heard. Fiercy would know more than I, or thou couldst ask their clerk. And the clerk? Tis a woman, I know that, but I do not know her name. Taylor. Yes, I love sewing clothing. Wouldst thou be interested in seeing or purchasing some of my creations? Sure. What article wouldst thou like to buy? Hood, dress, pants, tunic, heavy cloak. Dress. Dress sells for 45 gold. Not that willing to buy my price. Sure, why not? I guess I will carry that. Excellent choice. Is there something else that wouldst like to see? Yes, but not on the food line. All right, bye. Fairly well, my lord. Fairly well. What kind of dress did I get? Who picked up the dress? All right, This guy picked up the dress. That is a shitty dress. You can keep it. I'm leaving. Bye. You can keep the gold too. I don't even care. Your dress sucks. Here, kitty kitty. Who is that who hate cats anyway? Shimino, you hate cats? What the hell's wrong with you, dude? What is this? A pitcher. Okay. Let's talk to this guy. You see a man with a sour expression on his face holding a baby boy. As he sees you, his face brightens. What's your name?
I'm Ephraim, my lord. I am but a simple resident of Moonglow. What is thy name?
My lord.
Fine, my lord, if that is the title by which thou dost wish to be called. He looks at you, at the infant. The man is quite a snob, is he not, Mikhail?
Moonglow.
What about Moonglow? He shrugs. 'Tis a fair town, but a little too crowded these days. I hear it was a much nicer place back when Moonglow was a separate from the Lyceum. Much smaller. This place is too large to really get to know anyone. Not that I have had much of an opportunity, having to stay at home and take care of my son. He looks down at the boy, smiles, and tickles the baby's nose. Coochie-coo. This is not a job for a man. My wife should be home with the boy, not me. I should be out curling and living. This is what I ought to be doing.
Who's your wife?
My wife, Jillian. She's the scholar. She's a very good one, too. Not that I could not have done well. I could have better, in fact. But it is not worth arguing about now. She has her occupation, even if I do not have one. I should have a job, though. Dost thou not agree, my lord? This is not what a man ought to be doing. Staying at home, raising the children like this? 'Tis a disgrace. He begins to stroke the infant's small tuft of hair.
Not that I can agree or disagree myself, but anyway. Mikhail.
That is the name of my son. 'Tis a good name, yes?
Job. Me, I do not have a job, not a rerun like my wife has. All I do all day is watch over my little Mikhail here.
He turns to look at the baby, taking on a patronizing tone. Yes, I take care of thee, do I not? Yes, I do, I sure do. He kisses the boy and then looks back up at you embarrassed. Where was I? Oh yes. All I do is take care of the boy. What I should be doing is walking, not staying at home. That should be Jillian's job. She belongs here at home, not me. Leaving so soon? Oh, that's all right, my lord. I understand. Thou hast real man things to do. Yes, I do. Not like you, you loser.
There, yeah, it's nothing to do. Okay. There is a roll here. And a candle here. And what is this? Kitchen items. I feel like I should steal this. Steal it. Take it. Somebody take it. Leave that be. He caught me taking it. All right, it's okay. We'll leave. We'll leave. Let's see if he chases me. Doesn't seem like it. Seems like I got away scot-free. What is this? I don't know. I can't read it. I think that's two. That's an O. And that's, I don't know what. Okay, let me just look up. All right, fine, 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 fine. Or here. Hammer here. Hammer here. That's not a TH. Hammer here to enter. Can I pick? That did not work. Strange. Hammer. I don't have a hammer on me. I don't think. I gotta go find a hammer. I saw one earlier. I think it was at the other guy's house, the trainer's house. I gotta go find him. Let's check this house. No. Yeah, I don't really think so. Okay. This guy's place? Continuing voyages of the starship Enterprise. Amber. Your ongoing mission. No. To explore strange new worlds. Here we go. Here's a hammer. Yes, nice. I'll just carry that. Okay, let's go try and drop that hammer there and see what happens. Here it says hammer here to enter, so let's take a look. Let's put this giant fucking hammer right there. By Jove, I think thou art on the right track. The sign appears to have changed. Look at it now. Okay, fuck, I gotta translate this shit too. All right, going an NG, that's an NG right there. Keep pick item carefully to keep going. Oh my god, stop with the guys. Boom, boom, boom. Pick item carefully to keep going. Pick item, pick the lock. Strange, that did not work. Pick the item. Hold on. Pick. What? That duration doesn't seem very specific. No, it doesn't. I don't know what the hell it means. Open, motherfucker! Yeah, I don't get it. I'm still not getting it here. I wish I could cast some of these other spells. especially my level 8 spells. Death Vortex, Invisible All, Resurrect. Death Vortex, bitch! Energy Field. I wonder how I get the training to go up to other levels. Must be a way. I don't get it. What am I supposed to do here? This has got to be the last house on the island, though. Yeah, I guess I'm Googling it. About to search it up. So, lockpicks. I need to find some lockpicks. It just annoys the shit out of me. I'm like, come on, guys. Nowhere near me. Lockpicks. Alright, just skip one. Do 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 do. This is a different message. I think it changed. Okay. EE. Faces thee. A golden ring of truth faces thee. Okay. So I have to find a golden ring, I guess. I would think, because I bet that's really all it is. A golden ring of truth faces thee. Put a gold ring on there. Oh, I bet I have a golden ring. Hold on. Or do I have to find a golden ring of truth? An actual ring? An actual golden ring that says something to do with truth on it. I feel like probably not, but maybe. I know I have other rings, though. Orrery crystal and the small orrery. Like, what am I supposed to do with this thing? Oh, you know what? I should note that down real quick. Need to figure out. There you go. Save that. I gotta find someone with a golden ring. I could have sworn I had one somewhere. My wife would argue with that. There is no switch flipping going on here. Oh, here's a golden ring. Ring of invisibility. Please? Alright, so that didn't work. I guess I have to find a golden ring of truth now. That sucks. Oh, I didn't want to wear that. You can wear two rings, though. That's pretty cool. I didn't know that. Am I invisible still? Can't tell. I guess I'm not going to worry about it. Me? What's your name? I am called Adam, my lord. What's your job? I travel the world in search of very unique items to sell to museums. I already talked to you. Okay, bye. Okay, I've talked to everybody at Moonglow. Other than this one mystery, I don't really see anything to do here. This one mystery of getting into what's-her-name's house. I wonder what I'm supposed to do next. Okay, so that's the entire place here. Okay, so I gotta make another note in this thing. Golden Ring of Truth. There we go. Okay. Yeah, okay. I've definitely been through the entire map. I don't have a Ring of Truth. I don't have a Golden Ring of Truth. Let me go find that Moongate and see about going to the next Moongate and seeing where that is. Oh, here we're back in Britannia again. Aw, it's too bad. Okay, well, I hear that there is something over here that I haven't been to yet. Right over here. I think. But you know what? I may as well wait until morning. Do you hear here? Do you hear? Do you hear here? Here, 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 here. Oh my god, it's 9:30. I gotta call it a night here, guys. I have explored all of Mungo. Found not a whole lot. I have already been here, actually. A-O... I don't know what that is. E-R... I'm not sure what that is. Or that. That's another A. That's... I'm sorry. It's not an A. That's a C? No, I don't know what the fuck. I don't know what these letters are. I don't know them yet. Okie dokie.
Misa annoying. A character that's supposed to mimic Goofy, but it just comes off as pedantic and dumb. Because I didn't take any criticism from anybody. Anyway.
Let's go over the corner here. I want to say there's something here in the desert area. I'm going to go explore that just for a second. Then I'm going to call it a night, guys. You guys still hungry? Seriously? Oh, of course. It is 8 hours. There we go. Stop it.
Oh, hey! Put that cookie down!
Now!
Now!
Put that cookie down now! Oh, you want to pick a fight, huh? It's okay, I got you covered. I'm gonna take care of you. Ah! Stupid Cyclops. I've been through here, but I don't remember if there was anything here that was worth going to. No. Fine. Okay. Oh, I gotta put some, There you go. Oh, hey, here's a couple more. To battle, to arms! Oh, I guess we're murdering everybody! Oh shit, there's a lot of these guys here! Thy blood will soil the land! Ha ha ha! That's right, motherfuckers, you don't pick on the Avatar! He fucks with you! Now I can take your gold nuggets! Get out of here with my eye holes! Get on up out of here with my eye holes! Stealing the gold nuggets off of the Cyclops. Oh, that's right, this place. Yeah, there's no actual way out of here. Is there? Where's this go? Yeah, okay, there's a way out of here. That is not where I thought I would end up. I think I'm in the wrong spot. Okay, I'm on the right spot. There's some headless and wolves over here, but they can't get to me. Can I get to them? Nope, now they can get to me. There's a place to cross the water right here? Alright, I'll take it. Fuck everybody up, yeah! Curse thine offspring! There we go. Oh, more gold! More gold nuggets, of course. No more gold in the wolves, though. Okay. Let's cross the river. And I want to see if I just keep going this way. Like, there's going to be something, some desert over here that I haven't been to yet. The last place in the land I think I haven't been to. I just don't know the answer to a lot of these quests yet. So I'm not sure how to proceed at this point. I will probably finish up Badlands quest, because I've kind of been avoiding doing Badlands quest up to this point. But if there's nothing else to do, I may as well finish his up. Oh, what? Okay, gotta keep going. Here's the desert. Welcome to the desert of the real world. Okay, I've been here a little bit before. And I've murdered some scorpions before, but I want to say that there's something over here and down. that there might actually be something here worth going to. Let's take a look. Where's this pathway lead? To a cave, okay. This is the what? The Vesper what? That guy told me what it was, but I missed it. Huh. Band-aids. May as well take some. Foodstuffs. You know they'll come after me if I start eating their foods. Locked. Pick broke. Unlocked. Alright, hold on. Let's spread that. Let's not lose a pick over that shit. Right now, I know somebody has need of a pouch here. And we have three empty pouches. This is the Vesper something serpent? That, I think that snake was talking to me, but I'm not sure. Oh, the rats want to attack me now, huh? Guys, learn your lesson. It's the Avatar and his posse. We don't fuck around. You're gonna be dead rats soon. Dead rats now. Oh no, mate. Magic bolts. Well, Iolo takes bolts, but it's too bad that he doesn't actually have any freaking space for them now. Why? He's eight. Yes. All right. Cool. Well, there's definitely a set of caves over here in the desert. Thank you, old-fashioned one. What is this? Oh, it's a mining machine that actually works, but it makes nothing. Chunks of iron ore. Oh, maybe it does make something. Maybe it makes chunks of iron ore. Huh. Yeah, it does. Oh, look at that. That's cool. Oh, it drops an iron ore off. Nice. There must be a crafting thing going on in this game somewhere where I have to, like, take my iron ore and craft it into something. All right, let's keep going. Oh, this is the other side of that door. All right, I remember this. This was the magically locked door I couldn't get to before. With a gold nugget and a bottle. Why do I keep putting the gold nugget in my hand? Whatever. And a pickaxe. All right. So I want to say there's not much else here. Let's check the upper area. Oh, and some bats. Go punch that bat to death. You wanna punch that bat to death. All right, what's up here? Oh, another locked door I can't get into, of course. Magically locked, as I don't have the spell for it. And this is chunks of lead. So we can dig up lead as well, nice. In Fallout, you can punch with a rock. That is true. That is true. That is totally true. I had something I forgot about. This is the Vesper Mine, is what he's been saying. Okay. I wonder what the Vesper Mine is about. Well, we'll get back to that later. We're going to follow the pathway down here. Where is this and where is it taking me? There we go. This is the next village we're going to check out on Tuesday. Because there's totally people here. All right, cool. All right, let me give it a save. Start here, as usual. Bam. Go ahead and quit the game. All right, guys. Thank you, everybody, for hanging out.